Welcome back to my channel. I hope life is treating you guys good. I'm back again with another video. I just want to make a quick video to the response. And first of all, before I continue, I want to just take this time to appreciate everybody, because I've seen that we are at 2,000 subscribers, and I was really not expecting that I will get any subscribers at all, leave alone 2,000. So that is good. I'm in my kitchen, I'm cooking, and I'm vegetarian, so I made my vegetarian dish. As I wait for it to shimmer, I'm just gonna make a quick video right here to address my viewers regarding the last video that I uploaded, because I've seen that a lot of people were really triggered on that video, like really triggered. And y'all, people are just like, I know that when you leave the comment section open in videos, in most videos on YouTube, it almost feels like somebody has brought a bag of bees and just let them loose, and the bees are running at you, you know, when you make a certain video. And before I started in that video, I apologized. I said that it is not my intention to actually offend anybody, because I was making this video, and I just, in my YouTube channel, I do not want to be like silenced for speaking the truth. I want to come to this channel with the aim of being myself, being truthful, and just like speaking out of experience, like saying things the way it is. And I know that so many people get offended by people being blunt, and I don't know how to beat about the bush. I want to be myself 100% in this video, and I don't want to only make a video to please people or to make people happy or to like, there are things that are unfortunate in life, and if we talk about it, we talk about it. It's not like you do not have to. I don't want to dictate your emotions regarding the videos you've watched, but at the end of the day, we cannot try to silence people. Like, I was making this video in good faith, and I was talking out of absolute experience, with me living in the Emirates for 10 years, and I spoke about Arab men. Actually, when you make a video on YouTube, you have to really be careful with the wordings or with the titles. And that title, that video title, was meant to be with a question mark at the end, but it had a full stop. Like, just such minor errors will make people get so triggered to an extent, like people were coming at me like who cares, and people started being very racist. And you know, at a certain point, the comment section went ballistic. I had to actually disable the comment section at some point, because people were fighting, people were throwing insults at each other. Like, you know, like, first of all, you have to know that Arabs are very, very close-minded. They are people who are not really familiar with the outside cultures, because they are not very open like that. And they don't really like mingle with other people from other cultures to actually really understand what is going on in other cultures. The only cultures they know is their culture. There are women covering, there are women being modest, there are women being extremely traditional. And anything that is out of that is just like, it's just to them, right? So when I made that video, I was being very like blunt and being honest regarding how they see, just like if that they don't date African women, they don't date black women. And I know many of you, and that is the absolute honesty. I was not speaking because I was trying to bash African women. And guys, just try to accept that men have preferences in who they like and who they don't like. There are so many people, like for us, let's say, for example, us black women, we have bad experiences in our dating life, and most of these bad experiences, the baby mama issue, the abandonment issue, the mistreatment issues, the everything that is happening in our dating life, we have problem with most majority of African men and the way they treat their families and the way they treat us, beginning with our fathers or our immediate family. They have actually, in most cases, set a very bad example when it comes to, you know, even our fathers didn't raise us in a manner that we will have positive, let me put this thing down, that we will have positive outlook towards marriage or towards relationship or regarding men as a whole. So most of us have misconception or have this thing of all men, like when you hear people say all men are dogs, all men are cheaters, all men are liars, all men are blah blah, all men, and especially black men, a lot of us speak out of the experience of us having people come into our lives who, especially because we don't have good choice, we don't make good choices in men, so we bring this man, as unfortunately some family members we don't choose, we are born into them, and some of them have given us bad experiences. Not to go into a long story and not to bore you to death, some of you, again, I'm sure you are just going to go in comment section and be like, get to the point, like chill man, like just chill, give me a break and chill the F down, chill up. Listen, before you go in my comment section and try saying to me, get to the point, tell us what you mean, blah, 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 blah. Let me narrate a story. Jesus, let me narrate a story. We have our experiences with this man, and we've met, oh my goodness, sorry, the nippies. The nippies are mad. It's a rant video, even the nippies are ranting. Nipple to the winds, just like Patricia Bright says. So, we are like, we have experiences with black men that are not really good, some of us. And this has made us not like, some of us are wary, or we don't, you know, we don't go there with black men. Like, we are very like, oh, what do you want? Like you, how many baby mamas you are? Like, we have that guard. And that is how most men see us too. Some men have had bad experiences. And in some cities, they've had a lot of black women, majority, not all. Again, I said I'm not categorizing. A lot of us behave really badly, you know. We behave like we don't have morals whatsoever. And some men have generalized, unfortunately, and they have categorized us. And also with the same thing with the Arab men, including most men and even Arab men, they have categorized us. And mostly because in the Emirates, I promise you, you guys, I promise you, most women come here on visit visa, especially African women come on here on visit visa with the aim of selling their bodies. If you do not believe me, try going in the evening in Daira Street in Dubai. Walk there and have a look at the drama that is going on there with the African women standing there, and they are so desperate to an extent they don't even go with even rich Arabs. Rich Arabs will go to brothels and take women of their choices. They will not go to the street corners and pick up. Mostly, believe it or not, Pakistanis are the ones who are picking up these women. And these women have really, really, like, most of them are from Nigeria, some of them are from Ethiopia, some are from Kenya, some are from Tanzania. They are coming here, and some of them have been pimped out of Africa, out of these countries, to come here to do this business. So apart from the African, the Arab men being very close-minded and not being very, they don't mingle so much with other people to know what other characters are, other cultures are. Apart from that, leave that one alone. The way the black women in general, most of them, majority of them who come here, the way they act and the way they behave has made most men, including Arab men, not go there with them. And I told you guys, I give you guys the reason as to why Arab men think the way they do. And I'll give you, and some of you are like, oh, we don't care. We don't give a shit. They are towel heads anyway. They are smelling like shit. Their penises are this. And they hate their women anyway. Listen, partly what you say could be right. But even me, because I haven't lived with Arab men in general to just know the way they treat their women, I know that the Arabs in Dubai, I'm not defending anybody, but I know for sure that the majority of Arab high class, like the locals, I'm not talking about the people who immigrated here in 50 years time, or they were born here, or blah, blah, they are from some, you know, origins. I'm talking about the passport holders, because not just anybody. You just get to know that 90% of people in this country are not local Arabs. 10%, that is the Arab men, that Arabs locals who are Marathis with the passport holders and the nationals. They are very few, like they're not as many as the people who immigrated, as in the expatriates. They're not as many. So you're gonna have to forgive me in this video. I'm ranting up and down. You're gonna have to be patient with me. My thought process is all over the place. I'm being myself in my videos, and if you don't like that, I'm sorry. I'm just telling you guys as it is. I have seen this, I know this, I've had experiences with listening to stories. Women, I fly millions and millions and millions of people all over the globe. I get to chat to people, so I think I can say for sure that what I'm saying is true. I'm not fabricating anything. And in most cases, these women has made it horrible for us black women who are decent enough, who are coming here to just work, do our business and go back home, and no selling monkey business of selling punamis going on amongst us. They have really ruined it. Just the same way as the black men who treat women like shit have ruined it for the nice black men out here. You know, they have ruined it. You have made people think that all of them are the same. It is the stereotypes, unfortunately. And again, the black, what is it called? You guys were triggered so much in that video. It is so insane. And I would say that I was only speaking the truth, and I was only saying it as it is. I know most of you do not care about Arab men. But for the ones who are looking, it's not like all of you. There are some people who are looking forward to, like they cannot, like they don't mind dating this man. So just to have an idea of, in case you want to travel to the Emirates, to know how these people view non-Arabs or non-Arab women or black women as a whole. This was the reason why I was making this video. And I personally, I think that Arab men, as I said in that video, are good to look at. Most of them are really handsome. But at the end of the day, I am zero attracted to these men. I don't find them, they are good looking, but I don't find them attractive for me personally. And Arab men do not, if they don't find African women attractive, that is okay. Everybody have their own preferences, and we don't have to, us as African women, we don't have to be so salty when somebody says that a certain group of men do not like dating us, or do not go there with us, or whatever. Like, it is what it is. They don't like, yes, they don't like, just the same way as we might not like to be dating other people. Like, people have preferences in this life, you know. No need to us to get offended. And I was not making that video to make myself a pity, to feel like I need validation from Arab men. That I do not even have zero Arab friends. I don't have them, because They are friends amongst each other. The Muslim stays with each other. There is a lot of segregation here because of cultural shock. Everyone is sticking to the people they know, to the cultures they know, to the things they know, and all. Nobody mingles. Not so many people, like you would not find Arab men or Arab women friends with the British, and you know, drinking and like woohoo, like having parties in the bars and drinking and giving shots and like have. Doesn't happen here. It doesn't happen here. People stick to their own. People stick to their own in this region. And it is okay. It is okay, you know. That is what I was meaning, you know. It is okay to stick to your own. And even us, maybe we need to look at our women, but our men differently, because I know that we have stereotypes. And I know that we are dating out. We've had bad experiences. We've had bad fathers. We've had bad everything. We are like fed up with it. But at the end of the day, let's try to begin to switch our mindsets and date within us. Date each other. Love each other and whatever. Make a difference in each other. Don't mind my hand action. This is me when I am emphasizing on a topic. All right? And for you guys who don't like my attitude, I'm loud mouth. Oh my God. Sorry, guys. I know. M nipples are not happy. They ain't happy. They're not getting it. So many people were triggered in this video again. I know you're gonna tell me. Okay, and then again, I said something about Moroccans and Moroccan women. I say that they like dating local Arab men. They love Arab men. They chase after Arab men. Arab men like to treat their women in a sense of the woman in their life. They like to show off with expensive things, buy them monetary gifts and all. And Moroccan men, women who are here, most of them like this. Most of these women like this. Doesn't mean that all of them. I fly and I have people that I have worked with. I have got information. I've had stories all my 10 years of living here. And Moroccan women that date Arab men profess that they don't really date broke ass Arab men. They go with the rich ones for money and comfort. And somebody came into this video and was like, because I disabled the comments because people were fighting on to that session. I disabled, my hands are very like tired, and I'm trying to also not show my nippies, so let's put it like this. So yeah, and the women just, that one woman came to me and was just triggered, and she was just writing me this long ranting mail of how she thinks that I'm being disrespectful to saying that Moroccan women are chasing Arab men for money. Honey, you are not going out with any Arab man for money. That's you. But the majority of the girls that I have spoken to, they don't date no broke ass men, especially Arab men. They go with only rich Arab men. An Arab man will proudly flaunt a Moroccan woman in a sense of, I have money and look, I got her. And she's got Louis Vuitton, she got Louis Vuitton, she got all this stuff. She's been business class and all. And I say that most Moroccan women are lucky enough to marry into the royal family. There's something about Moroccan men and Arab men, you know, Moroccan women and Arab men. They love each other. That is what I said. And some of them go for each other for what they can give each other. The benefits they can get from each other. What is wrong about saying that? I didn't say Moroccan women are prostitutes. I didn't say that. I said that as much as, well, I didn't say that, but there are some who are actually here for that. They are actually selling their bodies for money. I know that most, there are women who are actually very, very, what is it called? Very traditional and very reserved and very prayerful, and you know, they pray five times and they're religious and stuff like that. But there are women who are Moroccans who cannot be bothered with that type of a lifestyle.
they go for it. They get what they want and they like what they like in Arab men. You know what I mean? So when you get triggered and feel like you want to feel like I need to be silenced for speaking the truth. Even yesterday in my last flight, I spoke to one girl, and thousands and thousands of people talk to people, especially Moroccans, talk to them. I know that you have Moroccan friends, and probably your friends are not that type. Well enough, we have a lot of prostitutes who are Africans in Dubai, black women, and me and my friends, we are not prostitutes. And it doesn't make me close my mind and say that they are not. They are, you know. They are good women, and they are also women who are all over the place with their bodies, trying to sell their bodies and whatever. And I'm not judging nobody. I'm just saying it as it is. Yes, you got triggered and you told me, oh, you should make a video and apologize to women the way you spoke. What is there to apologize for? For speaking the truth and for saying it as it is? There's nothing to apologize for. And somebody was just telling me, oh, if these are the kind of videos you're making, you're gonna lose subscribers. I had 2 subscribers and I was happy. I had only 2 and I was still happy. Listen, it's not about subscribers. It's about me making a diary, speaking to myself like a crazy woman, and other people watching me speaking to myself. That is what it is up in here. And if you don't like that, honey, there is a click out button. Ain't nobody got time for that. I'm not being rude. I'm just being me here. Nobody is gonna silence me. Nobody is gonna bully me. Nobody is gonna tell me nothing. I have the button to disable and enable comments if I want. If people are acting really angry and calling each other and fighting over the comment section, I will disable these comments. And you don't need to follow me in my other videos and comment and tell me, oh, why you know, like, what, you are a YouTube police or what? You know, just let people be. Let people make videos that they wanna make. If they get views, fine. If they don't get views, for me, to be honest, even if somebody doesn't watch my videos, I will sit down and watch it myself. That is how crazy I am. Like this video that I'm making, I'll watch it probably like as many times as I want, because I like to watch videos. I like to watch me. I like to listen to me. I like to laugh at my jokes. I like to laugh at myself. I like to high five myself. That is what is up in here. It's what is happening in here. So for you guys who are triggered, guys, you don't have to be, you can be offended all you want. Well, I don't need to tell you not to be offended. You can be offended all you want. But again, if you don't like my videos, do not watch it. Do not watch it. Move, honey. Move. You do not have to watch this video. I don't have to be like, oh, yeah, you know. I'm myself in here. I'm myself. This is the only place that I can be myself. I have to pretend on board to smile and greet everyone and, you know, like, be nice to people even if they spit on my face. This is the only place that I come to be myself. Why can't I be myself? Why? Why can't I be myself? Like, there were so many comments that were triggered that I would have if I had to make this video to actually, it would go up to the whole night me ranting over this. But just know that now I put the comma instead of a question mark instead of a full stop into that video. All of a sudden the comments have stopped. Why? Because people were like, I said that Arab men don't like black women, full stop. And black women were running like, how dare they say they don't like us? We are pretty. We are princesses. We are goddesses. We love ourselves. We are who we are. If they don't like us, so what? Honey, hold it. Hold it. Nobody said they do not like you individually. I just said the Arabs, the black women in Dubai. Are you in Dubai? Especially the ones especially like the remember that people have cultures, and there are some people who do not date out. They will fool around and F every woman they want and dip it and do it everywhere and dip it and do it there and here and every Tom, Dick and Harry. But when they finally are ready to marry, they'll come back to their own. They will come back to marry their own. That is what Arab men are all for. Their women are reserved. Their women don't have sex before they are married. It is illegal here. They get jailed for that. It is forbidden. They don't do that. So they will go and pick up women who are loose all over the place to sleep with them as much as possible. And then at the end of the day, they will come to their women. Ain't nothing wrong about that. They have preferences. You don't have to be offended. And just the same way you say they are racists. Me personally, I've had them harass me. Some of them, not all of them, harass me in the streets by hooting at me with a car, following me with a car and everything. But amongst the people in this country, I've been here 10 years, the Arab men, they are not, most of them don't even speak English. So how are they gonna, where will we meet? We won't even meet in the middle to communicate. So how, where, you know, apart from harassing and hooting and making noises, how are they going to be bullying me and to be like telling me, oh, you and meaning nigger. I don't like that one. Yeah, you and you coon, the way you same actually black people are more racist than Arabs. Even though they are very close-minded and they don't know what they are doing, because they are very, 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 very close-minded. For you people who are not close-minded and are traveled and are out there, you don't need to fight racism by being racist back. You can do better than that because you seem to be smart with all them comments. Anyway, guys, listen, I'm done ranting. My nipples are done ranting. It's time for me to eat my vegetarian food. My vegetarian food. And thank you for 2,000 subscribers. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. I'm being honest, you guys. I'm being very honest. I'm not beating about the bush. I'm saying it as it is. Give it a thumbs up. And again, if you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. Thumbs down never killed anybody. So listen, we have to just let people be. Let me talk my experiences. Let me give my stories. You're gonna come at me. You're gonna abuse me. I'm gonna delete you. Yeah, ain't no time for that here. I'm gonna delete you. Yeah, take it somewhere. Still take it elsewhere. Yeah. Okay, listen, I'm done. End of rant. Thanks for 2,000 subscribers.